Bueno, pues muchas gracias por estar en nuestros servicios sobre las redes sociales. Estoy muy feliz porque estoy hablando español y nunca lo hablo. Y no sé en verdad qué estoy diciendo, pero ¿sabes qué? Vamos a alabar en espíritu y en verdad.
With my
Hey, well, thanks so much for joining with us this coming week. I'm so happy and thankful that you're joining with us tonight, whether you're watching on YouTube or on Facebook Live or on IGTV, or maybe you're seeing this later on in the day. I simply just want to say thank you so much for tuning in tonight. My name is Alex, and we started a brand new sermon series last week titled Church in the Wild. And really, as we're going to be doing this sermon series for the next couple of weeks, we're going to be trying to answer this question. How can you and me be the church that God has called us to be in these wild times that we're living in right now? And so this is part two of Church in the Wild. And if you have your Bible, I want you to turn it to 2 Samuel chapter 12, verses 19 and 20. Because I want to read to you these two verses to be able to set us up into what we're going to talk about tonight. My title is Get Up and Worship. Get up and worship. And so let me give you a little bit of context into what we're about to read in 2 Samuel chapter 12. We're about to read about a character named David. We all know David. We all know David as the man who killed a giant named Goliath. We all know David as a man who at the end of his life was known as a man after God's own heart. But we also know that David was a shepherd. We also know that David was overlooked by his father and by his brothers. But at this moment in 2 Samuel chapter 12, David is none of that anymore. David is now the king of all of Israel. And although the Bible says that David was a man after God's own heart, I need you to understand that that doesn't mean that David was perfect. You see, David had flaws. David made mistakes. And one of his biggest mistakes was with a woman named Bathsheba. Bathsheba was married to a man who was in the army of Israel named Uriah. And the Bible says that David got Bathsheba pregnant. And the Bible says that David tried to trick Bathsheba's husband into believing that that baby was his. But in reality, it wasn't. It belonged to David. And David came to a point where he wasn't able to trick Uriah. So he did what he could do, and he put Uriah on the front line of the battle. And really what that meant is that David was sending Uriah to his death. The Bible says that Uriah ends up dying, and David ends up taking Bathsheba to be his wife. And we come to find out that Bathsheba gives birth to a son. But as this all happened, the Bible also says that God was not happy with what David had done. And so God sends a prophet named Nathan. He sends Nathan to go and find David and tell him that God had seen what he had done and that he wasn't happy about it. But he had also sent Nathan to tell David that he had forgiven David already. And so the Bible ends up saying that David confesses. He confesses to what he had done, but he was ultimately going to lose his son. He was ultimately going to lose his child because of the mistake that he had made. And this is where we find ourselves in this story in 2 Samuel chapter 12, where now David has gotten the news that his son, his child, is going to die. And David goes for 7 days without eating. David goes 7 days laying on the ground, begging God, crying to God, praying that God would heal his son. But ultimately, the fate of his son had already been decided. And so the Bible says that throughout those 7 days, David's advisors would come to him, and they would advise him to get up and eat, to take a moment throughout the day and get something in his system to be able to go throughout the day. But David would refuse. He would refuse because he was that obsessed with begging that God would save his child. We come to find out that on the 7th day, David's son passes away. And the advisors, they start to try and wonder how they're going to tell David, because they had seen how devastated he already was while the child was alive. And they were afraid of how devastated he would be after finding out that his child was now dead. Watch what 2 Samuel chapter 12, verses 19 and 20 says. The Bible says that when David saw them whispering, he realized what had happened. "Is the child dead?" he asked. "Yes," they replied, "he is dead." Then David got up from the ground, washed himself, put on lotions, and changed his clothes. He went to the tabernacle and worshiped the Lord. I want to talk to you from that. Get up and worship. You see, I love this because possibly on the hardest day that David could have ever faced, the day that he lost his child, possibly on the day that he possibly might have been feeling the most pain and the most regret, and I'm sure he must have been feeling brokenhearted as to losing what mattered to him the most, his son, the Bible says that David didn't stay in his pain. He didn't stay in his regret. He didn't stay on the thought that he had made a mistake. Instead, the Bible says that he got up. Man, I want to encourage you that if you and me want to be the church in the wild, you and me got to make a choice every day to get up. Every day when you wake up, you face a choice. You can either stay in your sin, you can either stay in your mistake, you can stay in your depression and your anxiety and your mistakes, or you can choose to get up. You see, David, I'm not saying that he didn't feel pain. I'm saying that David felt pain. He was feeling every bit of the regret that he had done something wrong and it was his fault. But David didn't stay in the pain. David didn't stay in the regret. It's one thing to feel pain and it's another thing to live in pain. It's one thing to feel regret and it's another thing to live in regret. Man, I want to encourage you. Choose today to get up. The Bible says in Proverbs that a righteous person may fall 7 times, meaning that you and me, we're gonna fail. We're gonna have trials. We're gonna have moments where we're gonna make mistakes. But guess what? It says that the godly person may fall 7 times. The righteous person may fall 7 times, but they get back up. David had made a mistake, but he didn't stay in his mistake. He got back up. Man, I want to encourage you. I don't know what you're passing through. I don't know what you've done, but get back up. God loves you way too much for you to stay in your mistake, for you to stay in your sin. He loves you way too much to be able to stay in your past. God is calling you to get up and walk out of your past and walk into your future. But if you and me want to be the church in the wild right now, we got to choose to get up. But I love this too, because the Bible doesn't just say that David got up. The Bible says that David, when he got up, he didn't go and complain to God. The Bible says that David, when he got up, he didn't go and get upset at God. No. The Bible says that when David got up, he went to God's house and he worshiped. Man, I love that. Because worship, you gotta understand, worship is about bringing God glory. And worship is one of the most powerful things that God could have ever left us. But I was having this conversation with one of my friends a few weeks ago, and he said this to me, and really it changed my life. He asked me, "Alex, do you know what is the only thing that we can give to God here on earth that we can't give to Him in heaven? It's worship from our pain. It's worship from our suffering. It's worship from our trials." Because the Bible says that in heaven, everything is gonna be made right. No more disease, no more war, no more suffering, no more pain, no more brokenheartedness. But as we're here on earth and we're facing all of those things, we got a choice to give God the worship that belongs to Him that we won't be able to give Him then. And David understood that even though he might have been feeling pain, God was still worthy of worship. Man, I want to encourage you. You might be going through a hard season, but God is still worthy of worship. You might be struggling. You might be upset. You might be frustrated with what's going on. I know we're in a pandemic, but guess what? God is still worthy of our worship. We got to choose that if we got to be the church in the wild, we got to, number one, get up. But number two, we got to worship. Man, how many times have we stayed in a season of life because we haven't gotten up? You see, the great thing about seasons is that as quick as a season begins, that's as quick as a season ends. Every season has to come to an end. This pandemic will pass. This issue will pass. The struggle you're facing, it will pass. But will you choose to get up and worship, or will you choose to stay in your pain? David could have easily said, you know what? I'm done. I'm done with this whole God thing. I'm done doing what I've done. I'm gonna stay right where I'm at, and I'm not gonna worship God anymore. I'm not gonna get up. I'm not gonna be able to be the same. But guess what? He decided to get up and worship, because David understood something. He understood, and that's why he wrote in Psalms 21 that when he looked up to the heavens, he knew where his help came from. It came from the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth. And my question to you tonight is this: do you know where your help comes from? Your help doesn't come from the White House. Your help doesn't come from a bank account. Your help doesn't come from anything else. Your help comes from the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth, the one who created you and who created me. And because he created you and me, and because he's still on the throne, guess what? He is still worthy of our worship. So if you and me want to be the church in the wild, we got to choose today to get up and worship. Man, I want to challenge you with that today. Get up today. What you've done, it's not bad enough. God is still obsessed with you. God is still in love with you. He's not mad at you. He is madly in love with you. He wants you to let go of the regrets, to let go of the mistakes, and get up. And he wants you to worship him. Man, so many times we spend our life worshiping this and worshiping that, when God has called us to him to worship him. Man, my question to you is that: will you get up and worship today, or will you stay in what you're going through right now? With your head bowed and with your eyes closed, if you say, man, I've been going through these past couple of weeks, these past couple of months, maybe even before the pandemic, I've been struggling with worshiping God. I've been struggling with getting up from where I'm at right now. I just can't see past my mistakes. I can't believe that God is still in love with me. Do you know what I've done? You know what? I don't know what you've done, but I do know who my God is. And God is in love with you. He wants you to choose him today. He wants you to get up and worship. And I'm not only talking about worship that has to do with a song or with a band. I'm talking about worship that has to do with our life. Worship is all about giving God glory. And you can bring God glory with your life, with what you say, with your social media. But my question is that, will you choose today to get up and worship? If you say, man, I want to choose today to get up and worship, I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Say, Jesus, come into my life. Forgive me of my sins. Wash me of my sins. Surround me with your grace. Fill me with your favor. And Lord, fill me with your spirit for now and forevermore. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. If you just made that prayer, you just made the best decision you could have ever made. But I want to encourage you that even though David said that his help came from the Lord, it's because he knew that he needed help. There were things that he was struggling with. There were things that only God could save him from. And maybe you're going through something right now that only God can save you from. I want to encourage you. Man, believe like David believed. Get up and worship, and know that your help, it doesn't come from anything else but the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth. Choose today to be the church in the wild. Father, I pray for every person watching this. I pray that God, from wherever they are, that they are seeing this, I pray that God, you would protect them. I pray that God, you would bless them. I pray that God, you would heal them. I pray that, Lord, you would change them from the inside out. I pray that, Lord, you would fill them with boldness and courage to be able to live like your children, to be the light of the world, to be the salt of the earth, to be everything that you've called them to be. I pray that you would fill them with courage, that today they would be able to get up from the mess that they're in, to get up out of their sin, to get up out of their depression and worship you. I pray that today they would be filled with strength, hope, and that today they would be filled with power from on high. And Father, I pray that, Lord, you would bless them. Cause your face to shine upon them. Protect them and bless them and guide them for now and forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hey, well, thanks so much again for being a part of our service tonight. If you prayed that prayer with us, then I would gladly encourage you to comment down below, "I prayed that prayer," and also click the link in our bio on our Instagram or on my personal bio on Instagram, and be a part of a Zoom call right after service tonight to be able to connect with you and be able to talk to you and be able to help you in whatever area that we can help you in. I love you. I'm praying for you. I'll see you next week for part 3 of Church in the Wild.